Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Miles Edgeworth Ace Attorney Investigations, or Ace Attorney Investigations Miles Edgeworth, because apparently it's backwards from the way you read all the other Ace Attorney games. So, in the last part, I had to double-click. In the last part, we were hearing Lang's reasoning behind the kidnapping stuff, I believe, and I believe I was stuck. Agent Lang isn't wrong. His scenario is certainly a problem. Very happy to do something. Yeah, how am I supposed to prove it? Let's see, it was no coincidence. Maybe I'm supposed to point out that there might be another kidnapper. Let's see.
Objection!
Yes! Oh man! I am top of the line! The kidnapping wasn't planned by just two people alone. I thought so. I was waiting for that. I thought something got added. So I went back and watched the video. And no, nothing gets added. But that works! Yeah! This kidnapping wasn't planned by just two people alone. And what kind of proof do you have of that? Quite simply, there were three kidnappers. Three! Yes. The long pause is necessary, sir. Four costumes were stolen from the Wild Wild West area's back room. We found one of them in the kidnapper's hideout. But as for the other three, we can assume they were being worn by the three different people. We also found a set of three cups and three folding chairs that we used in the hideout. It all clearly points to a three-man group. Well, there's one woman in it. And I believe this third person is the real mastermind behind the kidnapping. Well, who is this mastermind? It's Lance, obviously. I present to you the brains behind the kidnapping. Wait a minute, I'm supposed to point it out? Old Bag! It's Old Bag! Old Bag is clearly the brains behind the kidnapping. Other person fits the bill, right? Escapes. So it wouldn't be Ernest. Ernest is getting blackmailed. So I'm gonna go off on a limb and say the impossible. It's Lance. Did I do it right? Lance Amano. I knew it. I knew it. My suspicions were right. Yes, the abduction was, in fact, schemed up by Lance himself. Recall what he said when he appeared before us. Awesome song, go. Did you see the faces of your kidnappers?
No, I didn't see their faces, but two. One was a woman.
However, there were three kidnappers, which is direct contradiction to what he said.
But I only saw two people.
This guy was being held hostage. It's possible he couldn't see all three of them.
Ah, yes, about when you were being held. I have my doubts about what happened then. Lance, would you mind telling us what happened while you were being held captive?
I really don't remember much anymore, honest. But if I don't tell you at least something, you won't believe me at all, will you?
That's because you're the real mastermind! I knew it! Unless I'm wrong, in which case, I'm wrong. Which would suck.
I was kidnapped yesterday morning. They had me shut in that room, blindfolded the entire time.
But then how'd you escape? But the kidnapper suddenly disappeared from the time I heard the rain falling outside.
My hands were cuffed, but it was a stroke of luck that they left me alone.
And you untied them how? I mean, got them out.
I made my escape and ran away from that room as fast as I could.
Through the underground passageway, I presume. Are you okay?
Sorry, I really didn't want to recall that horrible ordeal, but... But now you believe me, right?
No, not quite yet.
Ugh, how could you not? Why do you look at me with
icy daggers in your eyes? Because he's a prosecutor, and because they're all like that.
I'll have you know, Agent Lang, a prosecutor's eyes are for discerning the truth. And should they be interrupted to be cruel at times, then so be it.
There's a sticking point in Lance's testimony. Let's see what he offers when I push a little.
Let's do it! Rebuttal Lance's testimony!
I was kidnapped yesterday morning, and they had me shut in that room blindfolded. Really? Then how did you see? No, actually, no, I want to press that. You were blindfolded? How did you get off the blindfold and the handcuffs?
By that room, you mean the room in the kidnapper's hideout, correct?
Yes, but I was blindfolded the whole time, so I didn't know that until I made my escape. Then how'd you know one of them was a girl?
Then you were in the same room as your kidnappers. They spoke in hushed tones, but I could catch bits of the conversation. It was definitely two people. One of them was definitely a woman.
I was scared. I could tell they were nearby, so I didn't dare make a move.
Okay, that's... My hands were cuffed?
Then how'd you get them off, huh?
Then those cuffs on your wrists, I suppose you were still cuffed in that case. I'm well aware of how I'm chained to reality. I couldn't find the key, so I'm afraid that I'm stuck like this.
Oh, he's still wearing them. That makes sense.
Oh, I didn't notice. Even though I escaped from that jail cell, I will forever be a prisoner. I made my escape and ran away from the room as fast as I could.
I want to know about that whole you being blindfolded thing.
How did you manage to escape? I wanted to get out of there, but the door leading outside was locked, which is why I had to use the underground passageway to make my escape.
Remember our escape to be equally as hard.
This is an invaluable piece of testimony. I mustn't let it go unexamined. The door leading outside was locked tight, so I had to use the underground passageway. The door wasn't locked.
The door wasn't locked.
You silly goose. Check a button for details. I actually don't care.
Objection!
But the door wasn't locked. Let me tell you. You say the door leading outside was locked, but was it really?
We're talking about that room behind the saloon front, right? Look, I heard that it took quite a few men to get that thing open, right, Sheena?
Yes, that's correct.
Then take a look at this. What is that? A sword? It's not especially reliable. It's not especially reliable one if it's broken like that.
Allow me to start from the end. My conclusion is that the door was never locked. It was simply held shut by the sword which was used to jam the handle. Lance, even though your hands were cuffed together, you could still use them. If that's the case, then why did you not just simply remove the sword and escape?
Why didn't I? I was disoriented.
Yes, that's it. I didn't notice it.
Well, if you have to come up with excuses... As if I should accept such a bold-faced lie.
You locked yourself in that room because you had to make yourself look like the victim. But you did not, in fact, possess the key to the door.
That is why you used a prop sword to improvise and create a prison of your very own.
Yeah.
Bad reading skills for the win. You've been making this guy out to be one of the kidnappers for some time now.
Actually, it's only been about 5 minutes.
I wonder if you've gotten something very important. If you've forgotten something very important along the way.
And what would that be?
A motive. What else? Do you honestly think that an upright pure boy like him would hatch up a completely pointless scheme such as kidnapping himself?
Damn, I didn't know he had
a close-up awesome face. Awesome.
This proves that Lance did indeed have a motive to commit this crime.
I don't know, but I'm gonna guess it's this letter, because it's for Lance.
To put it simply, Lance has a very urgent need.
For money?
Yes indeed, tender lender coming back.
This is hardly your typical love letter, it is in fact a collection bill. It appears our upstanding boy has accumulated quite a debt. Isn't that right, Lance?
Wait a minute. I just realized something. Did his handcuffs fly off?
He can just take them off.
And he's not.
Looks like it's hard being the son of a rich man too. It must be rough when you have to resort to stealing from your own old man, huh?
All right, I give up. I abducted myself.
Lance,
I knew it. I knew you were a suspicious man. I knew you were a very suspicious man.
It's over, Lolly, Pop. In this life, we really are bound to our fates after all. All I wanted was to go with you to a new town, somewhere where no one would know us. I wanted us to be well off with that $1 million, but now that dream is over.
Oh, Lance.
Then you are giving yourself up.
Yes, I had planned to run away from this world with my lollipop. Oliver even helped us with the plan, but then he had to go and stab us in the back. He turned on you. Maybe he didn't want us to split the ransom money. That's my guess. It happened almost right after you made the drop-off. When we were alone, he attacked me all of a sudden. After a brief struggle, I was able to contain him and keep him under control. We left him inside that room as Lolly and I made our escape. We wore different costumes and split up. Lolly left first in the Blue Badger costume. That would mean that the person Officer Meekin saw was Miss Pops. But right then, the old man just had to wake up! I was careless, and he tackled me pretty hard from behind. Then Oliver put on a Bad Badger costume, took the suitcase with $1 million and ran. I contacted Lolly right away and warned her that he had a gun. They had no idea that they were related, so I thought it could only end badly. I still don't believe it. That person was not my father. Why did she threaten to cut her hair? Because if he was, I just killed my own father. Lolly, then it really was you? Oh, great. Back to Lolly's testimony. And she's threatening to cut her hair. That man was not my father. I mean, because at the stadium, there was a Bad Badger pulling the suitcase with the $1 million in it. But that badger pointed his gun at me, aiming to shoot me dead. That's why I used the gun I got from Lance. There was a gunshot. The other person crumpled to the ground and I ran, scared for my life.
I think the big picture is finally coming into focus, don't you?
Lolly, forgive me. I didn't think it would turn into something so frightening. If only I could have protected you. So, Miss Pops, she shot her own dad without even knowing who it really was.
If what she says is true,
are you saying she's lying? But why would she lie about something like that? What purpose would it serve?
You would be surprised how often people lie without even realizing it themselves, Kay.
Huh? What's that supposed to mean?
What I mean is, listen very carefully to her confession once more and you'll see.
I hope I didn't miss the Easter egg, because I'd be sad in face.
You know, just as a side note, I hope I'm not stuck in having to replay this entire case just to see that Easter egg.
That is why I used the gun I got from Lance. There was a gunshot, the other person crumpled the ground, and I ran scared for my life. Poor Miss Pops. What will become of her, Mr. Edgeworth?
She seems to be telling the truth regarding what happened at the stadium. However, I don't believe it to be absolutely correct. Listen very carefully to her confession once more, and you'll see.
Is it the fact that, you know, the badger costume?
I'm curious of one thing.
Wait, I'm curious. I want to know if the gun she got was the fake gun.
You shot Mr.
Dacon.
Yeah.
Miss Pops?
Yes, I shot him.
And that, as they say, is that.
Agent Lang, Miss Pops is far from done. She hasn't even finished her testimony yet.
You're going to continue questioning her? What a waste of time.
Miss Pops, if you please.
All right.
There was a gunshot and the other person crumpled to the ground. I ran scared for my life.
Did you shoot the gun?
Did you take off immediately following the gunshot?
Yes.
And you didn't attempt to approach the victim at all after he was shot?
I was scared.
I don't blame you. I would have done the exact same thing.
Poor Miss Pops.
I have a couple of suspicions, but...
Hold it!
Please calm down and let's slowly talk through this.
But I...
All you have to do is simply tell us what happened at the stadium. Leave it to us to search out the truth. Can you do that for me?
Alright, so at the stadium...
Hold it!
That was the ransom money, wasn't it?
Yes, that's how I was able to identify Mr. Deccan almost immediately. Well, it was all thanks to what Lance told me.
And what did he tell you?
Well, he called me on my cell phone and told me that Mr. Deccan had betrayed us and ran off with the ransom money. And about how he had a gun.
hold it!
Someone had a fake gun. Were you able to clearly see the gun?
Yes, I got a very good look at it while it was pointing, while it was pointed at me. Oh, Father, why would you try to shoot me?
Do you really think a father would try to shoot his own daughter, Mr. Edgeworth?
I don't know. I don't want to believe it myself, but it's true. But it's true, my father's left arm was raised with a gun in it. Pointed straight at me. I'm about to die, I thought.
Miss Pops, please calm down and take a deep breath. And then would you allow me to please hear that last statement one more time?
Yes, of course. But that badger pointed the gun at his left hand at me, aiming to shoot me dead.
What? That was it? What?
Okay, anyways. I have here a dossier of your father. And according to this, your father was right-handed.
What? Random guessing for the win, but what?
Jeez.
Then...
The person pointing a gun at you from atop the stage was not Mr. Deckard. Hold on there, Mr. Prosecutor. I think you need to take a refresher course. A bad badger has a model gun attached to his right hand. Which is why the only hand he could have held the real gun in was his left. Isn't it possible that it went down like that?
Agent Lang, were you paying attention to what Miss Pops was saying? Then again, I suppose I can't expect someone who's never set foot in court to catch it.
Enough with that smugness. Out with it already.
Miss Pops told us earlier. There was a bad badger pulling the suitcase with $1 million in it.
According to you, the bad badger had a gun in his left hand, which would mean that he was pulling the suitcase with his right hand. Is this correct, Miss Pops?
Yes, exactly. And I'm sure it was the bad badger. It had those huge sunglasses on its face.
But if that's the case, even I can see there's a huge contradiction.
Yes, Miss Pops claims to have seen the bad badger. And yet the bad badger had both of his hands full. The two pieces of information contradict each other, so one must be wrong.